All right, we're going to look at this mechanical system, and our objective is to write the differential equations of this system and then convert those differential equations into a block diagram and ultimately end up in Simulink for doing a simple simulation of this system. So the first thing we're going to do is to write the equations of motion. We need the free body diagram of this, and so I'm just going to go here and put the pin, and then we're going to say okay, here is the free body diagram. It's the very first thing we're going to do. To do the free body diagram, we need to define that the motion is going to be positive this direction, and then what we will do is we need to write a simple free body diagram where we show the forces. Obviously the weight is down, this is mg here, and then if this is up from the equilibrium position and we move it up, this is going to move it down. So if that's the case, you're going to have a minus k times x. This other component also, if we move up, is going to be in the opposite direction, which will be minus b times x dot. And so this is the free body diagram. Now, from this free body diagram, we want to apply that the summation of the forces equals to mass times the acceleration. And in doing that, we say, okay, this is the force minus mg minus k times x, b times x dot equals to mx double dot. Yeah? Summation of the forces equals to mass times acceleration. What I suggest is that you use this form that it's expressed in here as a summation and with the highest order derivative on the right hand side. The reason is that this form makes it easier for you to do the Simulink graph. Let me explain what I just said. And here is the summation point in here is going to be like that. And if we relate this equation to this picture, you have that in here, you have a contribution of mg. You also have a contribution of k times x. And this of b times x dot. Okay, this is equal to, see what's in here, mx double dot. What I'm trying to tell you is that we have just done converting the differential equation that you see, we had it in algebraic form, in this case with symbols, we have converted into a little picture. And my suggestion is that you start with the summation because it organizes all the terms and sets you up to build the block diagram from there. Now, granted that the block diagram can be obtained by starting from basically anywhere or in any term, but I find it a little easier, and students, based on their feedback, tell me that you could do this representation of the sum, and it becomes very obvious what you need to do. So I think what I would like in this case is complete a block diagram that I have started by coming in here and saying, okay, if I multiply this by a gain of 1 over m, I would obtain x double dot. If I process this x double dot through an integrating block, I will produce x dot. And if I do it again, I will produce x. So good habit to put the scope in here. Okay. And then you see here, this is minus bx dot. It's very obvious we have x dot in here. So if we just multiply this by b like this, we will definitely finish this connection. And this is x. You see, is obvious that x from here, if we multiply by a gain of k in here, then obviously this will connect here. We have finished the block diagram. So the point here is that we had, this is our equation in here. This is the second order differential equation. And in here we did use the representation of the equation as a sum in here, and we put it down here. This was the summation point. In here, of course, this is a minus, and a minus over here too. So how do you actually convert this into Simulink? What we do is, first of all, we'll reduce our window here so that we have it handy in a set of notes, you may say. Let's see, here we go. How come we are missing a... Let's see. We're missing just a line here. So we'll correct it here. Okay. So there it is. What we're going to do is we go to my programs and now MATLAB. So Simulink is a toolbox of MATLAB. So we are going to use this tool, but first we need to call MATLAB and have it running to be able to do it. So from here is that we have the MATLAB window running right now. So this is, we're gonna do Simulink, and then we will come back.
Okay.
Yes.
Can you maximize that other window name, please? Okay.
This one? You want to see the whole process in there?
Maybe.
Uh-huh. All right, so we have in here so this is going to help us guide the so in here he didn't like it me writing it in capital letters. So okay, we're gonna do in simple letters. Oh, there you go. Send me a link. Oh, I did. So in here I need to open a new example so that we do a simulinking here. This in here we're gonna put the this is the common the use blocks. This MATLAB we can put it away and click on the commonly used. And so take a look what we need. See in here we need the summation points, this gain, the integrators, the gain in here. So what I would do is not just put in here the different ones that I need. We need like three of these. So I'm just gonna put them in here for now. We need this too, and we also need this one. And we need this one, and I think that might be basically what we need. No, we still need the integrators. The integrators, there's two of those, and this will go in here, and then there's two of these. I would put this one's the reverse control I because they go on to the opposite sign. So in here we need to make this bigger, and you know we don't need two but we need three, and all those three are minus. Okay, so you have in here from here to here, and you can actually, if you press control key, the control key, and then you press the first element, the control key, and then the second one, it will draw the very quickly. This is and then you have the second one. See? And so what we have done is we have translated our graph into the Simulink notation here. What we need to do now is to put the same labels in here as we have. This is not just the labels but indicates the parameters, and then you have this one in here. I think we need to make it a little bigger, 1/m. Yeah, and then you have this one is the value is B, and this one the value is K. Yeah, so I think we should be ready to go. Let's put this scope in here, and at the MATLAB prompt, we should be able to put those numbers. So you in here we have like m is equal to 1. Then you have b is equal to 2. Okay, and then we have, no, m is not 1, is c mass times epsilon, yeah, okay. Then we need to define the variable g, which is 9.81. Oh, I hadn't put the value of b is equal to 1, and then g is equal to 9.81. And so if we run, if we click on this, if we have everything defined, and we click on run, we should be able to see a simulation. See here? And now we have one error in here. For example, where did that happen? Right here. Because actually it's good that this happened, because now we can fix it. It needs the value of k. And I